We continue in the appendicular skeleton with the pelvic girdle, which consists of the two hip bones or coxal bones. Let's look at an image of them. This is the pelvic girdle, which exists bilaterally. At the posterior end, they are joined by the sacrum. At the anterior end, they are joined by the pubic symphysis, which is fibrocartilage. So the pelvic girdle itself, let's look at one side, consists of three bones. The ilium is the superior portion. The pubis is the inferior portion on the anterior side. And the ischium is the inferior portion on the posterior side. All three bones of the pelvic girdle, the ilium, ischium, and pubis, meet at the socket, which is called the acetabulum, where the femur or thigh bone will insert into to form the ball and socket joint of the hip. So here are your three regions of the pelvic girdle, ilium being superior, ischium being posterior and inferior, where the pubis is the anterior region, which joins up to that pubic symphysis. There are many landmarks on the pelvic girdle. Let's go through some of them that we label in lab. On the ilium, we have the posterior superior iliac spine, the posterior inferior iliac spine, anterior superior iliac spine, and anterior inferior iliac spine. So those are your four iliac spines in the ilium. We have an iliac crest. On the inside, we have an iliac fossa. We have this greater sciatic notch. Then we'll move to the ischium, and we see this lesser sciatic notch right here with the ischial spine between the two notches. This region of the ischium is what we sit on, and that is the ischial tuberosity. Very important landmark. There's the acetabulum, which is the socket where all three pelvic girdle bones meet. The obturator foramen is a large hole for blood vessels and nerves. The pubic tubercle is the anterior region where the pubic symphysis will articulate with. In this slide, we see the difference between the female and male pelvis. Female pelvis looks more shallow, where the male pelvis sits a little taller. The female pelvis has a larger or a greater capacity in the pelvic bowl than the male pelvis does. The female pelvis tilts forward, making it look shorter, where the male pelvis does not tilt as much, therefore appears taller. So the female pelvic outlet is wider and broader, where the male pelvic outlet is more heart-shaped. So the overall result here is a larger capacity in the pelvic inlet area for childbearing reasons.